All right, let's try this again. It is never an exaggeration to say that a great teacher can change a student's life. Education becomes so much more than just conveying knowledge. It becomes an opportunity to provide guidance, new outlooks, and inspiration. I want you to take this and think of Appleby. However, instead of choosing an individual like an actual teacher, think of ventures such as Tamagami, co-curriculars, and service trips. By doing so, we can see how some of the best teachers actually come from experience and personal pursuits. I like to call these life's teachers. Having turned 18 years old very recently, I took some time to reflect to find some of the life's teachers that had the best impact on me. I found that the most common results when you searched life best teachers while growing up in Google were camping out in a tent, running your own lemonade stand, and raising money for charity. Having done each of these growing up, I can agree that they are very impactful experiences. Camping out teaches humility, running a lemonade stand can put your self-confidence to the test, and raising money for charity brings gratefulness. Each of these were definitely involved in my growth as an individual. However, I wouldn't say that any of these were my life's best teacher. So I continued searching, when one day my Spotify playlist in the background switched to David Bowie's Let's Dance, and I realized that my life's greatest teacher was competitive dance. It was after a year after my first hip-hop class at the Canadian Dance Company that I entered the immersive and demanding world of competitive dance. As a 10-year-old, this pursuit immediately brought significant change to my life. As all my free time suddenly vanished, my catchphrase at school quickly became, "Sorry, I can't, I have dance." And while most of the other kids were tying their cleats or playing video games, I was leaping across a wooden floor and shuffling in tap shoes. Yet this divergent interest from my peers was a small sacrifice compared to everything that dance gave me. Dance brought me joy from competing nationwide in front of hundreds or even thousands of people. It led me to adore 80s music, and also led me to auditioning for Family Channel's The Next Step, keyword auditioning. But most importantly, my commitment to dance taught me three powerful life lessons. Life lessons that sparked understanding, new outlooks, and ultimately shaped me into who I am. I share these lessons with you today with the goal to encourage you to see how my experiences can also change your mindset and life. For those of you who don't know, being a competitive dancer means that you have to take ballet classes. And this caught me off guard because I really only began dancing with the intent of learning hip hop. So I found myself in uncharted territory when I had to put on tight black ballet shorts, a white tank top, and snug ballet shoes, as they are completely opposite from the baggy shirts and pants I wore for hip hop. To make matters worse, when I entered my first ballet class, my teacher called us to do a drill called the pirouette line. To clarify, a pirouette is a spin you do on one foot. And this is something I did not know going into my first class. So I was overcome with fear. I stood at the end of the pirouette line, rigorously examining my fellow dancers as each of them, having taken ballet before, spun a beautiful pirouette. "All right, Adam, your turn," my teacher said. Now, as much as I would love to tell you that I managed to perform a pirouette that was so beautiful, so mesmerizing, so elegant that it brought tears to my teacher's eyes, that was not the case. Immediately after pushing off my back foot to spin, I gracefully slammed onto the wooden floor. When I got back on my feet, I was greeted with giggles from my dance mates and constructive criticism from my teacher. After class, I limped to the car with the bruised knees and a bruised ego. And when I got home, I told my parents I was done dancing. I figured if competitive dance required ballet and I wasn't good at it, frankly, the best option was to quit. Thankfully, we decided that I would keep dancing for at least another month. And if I still felt the same afterwards, I could quit. In the span of that month, I must have fallen several dozen more times until I finally spun a single pirouette. Yes, it was wobbly, and it didn't bring tears to my teacher's eyes, but still, a pirouette. So, at my dance studio, ballet was mandatory, as it was the foundation for all other dance styles, including hip-hop. I knew that if I wanted to continue with the dances that I loved, I needed to master ballet. I worked tirelessly on strengthening my technique while appearing poised and grateful, and each time that I saw an incremental improvement, I was motivated to continue. Eventually, I improved to such an extent that my teacher choreographed me to perform a pirouette center stage at our national competition. In life, and even at Appleby, there will be situations when you have to follow mandatory pursuits that aren't the most appealing or you aren't very strong at in order to achieve a long-term goal. When these situations arise, it is crucial that you remain perseverant to push past these challenges so that you are able to achieve said goals. Had I quit competitive dance because of my initial difficulty with ballet, I would not only not have performed a pirouette center stage at nationals, but I would have missed the opportunity to grow in character from my other lessons, such as my next lesson, which is the individuality within teamwork. I'd like to tell you guys all a short story about the Temptations, except I don't mean the jazz phenomenon of the 70s, but my five-boy jazz small group during my second year of competitive dance. We each wore shiny blue suits to mimic our namesakes and competed to get second overall at our international competition. But before our success, we had to go through a long journey in training to become a strong group performance. After the first day of choreography, it was clear that each of us boys were a different type of dancer. While I excelled at hip-hop, others were extremely flexible and extremely acrobatic. Luckily, our choreographers recognized each of our individual skill sets and built the entire dance on exactly that. Instead of having an entire dance that was easy and filled with choreography that we could all do and would take us nowhere, they made it so that we each danced to our strengths while challenging ourselves. Finding this balance between individualistic highlights and cohesive teamwork was the combination, plus our shiny blue suits, that made our group so successful. We really were better together. Being students at Appleby, there are so many times when you'll be working with others. It could be during a club, co-curricular, on a service trip, or even just in a class. In these situations, don't stress about being at a different skill level than others. Simply make sure that while working with your team, you are drawing from your individual strengths to take the group further. In other words, use teamwork to get things done, but draw upon your team members' individual talents to make things great. Finally, I personally believe that the last lesson is most important. Competitive dance is one of the most time-consuming sports there is. I personally spent over 20 hours a week at the dance studio. This means 20 hours of sweat, soreness, and struggle, and this can come from learning several hours of choreography or focusing on a single count of eight for an entire session. I learned that in order to have the motivation to push through these challenges and durations, you need a passion, and I'm glad to say that I had it. Every hour spent perfecting a single move and every early morning didn't bother me because it was all worth it in the end. I simply loved putting in the work to have it all culminate to performing on stage, which gave me an exhilarating joy that couldn't be replaced. Of the weekly 20 hours I spent, I could have easily spent another 20. Well, maybe not easily, but I would have tried. The best way to see where passion currently lies with you is think about school and think about your favorite class and not so favorite class, and how you feel when completing the work from those two. For myself, being a more left-brain individual, that's physics and English respectively. I can spend an entire day doing physics problems, but tell me I have to write an English passage analysis, I'm suddenly the king of procrastination. I spend an hour on YouTube watching videos like the top 10 ways to cook broccoli, which is an 8-minute steam, or I tell myself to take an hour nap so I can let myself think. The feeling that I have with physics, like you probably have for your favorite activity or class, is in a way quite similar to the feeling that I have with dance. It's a happiness and motivation to continue despite challenges, conflicts, and long durations. And that's the essence of passion. Except, while dance helped me realize what passion was, it was my parents who truly showed me why passion was so important. Not long ago, both my parents switched their paths for long-term careers. My dad switched from his job of consulting to following his entrepreneurial spirit and opening his own bakery. He spent about 8 months in training, learning the ins and outs of running a bakery, and still works hard every day to grow his business. And my mom, after working 9 years in the medical industry, is now following her passion by becoming a real estate agent. When I go home on weekends, I see her working diligently, preparing for real estate exams and showing houses to clients. I have watched both my mom and dad in awe as they continuously work for what makes them happy while raising my brother, my two sisters, and I. And I can promise you that's no easy task. Words can't describe how lucky I am to call such two amazing role models my mom and my dad. Dance and my parents combined helped me learn that being practical is not doing what's easier. No, being practical is doing what makes you happy. Don't settle for nice, don't settle for familiar. Keep pushing until you find that something that resonates with your core. This can come from interests, peoples, books, clothes, art, music, movies, you name it. Following your heart to find your passion, every aspect of your life is never a mistake. I believe that a quote from Denzel Washington truly illustrates this. He says, "You never see a U-Haul behind a hearse." In other words, it's not about what you have, because you can't take that with you. It's about what you do. Are you happy? Are you following your dreams? Senior twos, our era at Appleby College is coming to an end. Whether you came to Appleby as a middle schooler, upper schooler, or senior schooler, we all are about to head off to the next steps of life and have more freedom than ever before. So it is important that with this freedom, we are following our hearts and our passions. Do what makes you happy, not what's easy, and incredible things will follow. Middle school, you have just begun your journey at Appleby College, and I am so grateful to have been a part of it. It is amazing to see each of you develop as individuals and as leaders as you find your interests and join the Appleby family. Remember to let your passions guide you in high school, and I look forward to seeing how far you come in senior two. I have had many great teachers in my life. Mr. Alexander taught me my multiplication tables in grade school. My Nana taught me how to cook a delicious tiramisu, and Michael Scott from The Office taught me that humor can get you through anything. However, none of these teachers could have been as pivotal to me as was competitive dance. The lessons from dance will always stay with me, and my experiences as a competitive dancer have prepared me for any challenge I will face. And I am proud to know that my younger sister has the opportunity to learn these same life lessons as she dances competitively now. To summarize everything into one sentence, competitive dance has shaped me into who I am, and the lessons from it that I share with you today are to embrace your individuality, not to give up, and to follow your heart. Now, will you please rise to sing my favorite hymn, 401, My Life Flows On, an Endless Song. Thank you.